Welcome to the Investment Properties for Sale Show, folks. Thing is selling at or above list. We are going to provide you guys with complete transparency and education. We take you to the video tour of HoltonWiseTV, giving it to you straight. Where are my cash buyers at, right? That's what I need today, folks, because this one we got for you, this is a cash-only deal, y'all. 2940 East 115th Street, Cleveland, 44104, right? 19-9, right? You read that right. 19-9, one of, if not the cheapest houses available in the entire city of Cleveland or all throughout Ohio, realistically. 19-9. But of course, you know, for the price of 19-9, folks, it's obviously going to need some work, right? Of course, it's going to need repairs, right? I mean, shit, you go to Home Depot or Lowe's right now, and I think a piece of plywood is close to the cost of this entire home. You know what I'm saying? But you guys get in there. This is going to be perfect for the DIYer, right? The investor. This is not really a great out-of-state investment, in my opinion, unless you are a seasoned out-of-state investor. I mean, it's obviously got some uniqueness, but it does come with something pretty sweet. Check that out right there. You see that? Yeah, that is not a normal boarded-up window. No. That is the Ghetto Express edition of a boarded-up window. That is a coffee table, I believe, that is being utilized to board up this window. That's the kind of sweet stuff you get, right? But anyway, yeah, I don't think this would be, like, the best investment for, like, a rookie investor, right? This is definitely a more advanced investment, right? Like, I know a lot of people, when they're just getting into real estate, they see super cheap stuff, and they're like, oh, that's good. It's a really cheap property. That's like a training wheel property, and then I'll move up. Now, not always, right? I mean, yeah, you don't want to go buy like a 100-unit apartment building as your first deal, but this is definitely not a rookie deal here, right? So I would say the kind of buyers that would make the most sense for this. I mean, don't get me wrong, though. Like, I'll take anybody's money who wants to buy the thing. If you're out of state and you're a brand new investor, you think you can make money on this, sweet. As long as your cash is green, we will accept it. But I think setting people up for success is important, and I think the best types of buyers for this would be local investors, who do their own construction, property management, renovation, handyman, right? That's going to be, first and foremost, the people that have the best opportunity to make a lot of money here, right? Because as you see, you need to do everything. The house needs a full renovation, top to bottom. I mean, we're missing furnaces. We're missing electrical wiring, right? I mean, you guys know, neighborhoods like this, a house goes vacant. Woo, boy, that copper is as good as gone. And then, of course, it is sold, and then it is magically turned into crack or heroin, whatever you prefer. Woo! You could smoke it. You could snort it. You could shoot it, whatever you want to do. If you got copper, that's what you're going to do with it, right? So, obviously, the next person that renovates this house is going to want to put in PEX plumbing. Some people like to do PVC. I don't like PVC. I think PVC is terrible, dude. Obviously, here in the Cleveland market, it's very, very cold in the winter, and frozen pipes are a freaking nightmare. With the PEX system, you have a little bit more leniency to, like, breezes and dropping temperatures and a little expansion, right? Those PVC ones, man, they're super cheap, right? So PEX is the name of the game for a property like this. But, yeah, local investors who are familiar with the neighborhood, right? You put in Section 8 tenants here, which I highly recommend, right? It's a volatile neighborhood, right? Non-payment of rent is kind of a big issue over here. So you get the government-guaranteed rent, right? A CMHA tenant, Section 8, Eden, right? Any type of voucher program. CMHA and Section 8, by the way, guys, same thing. CMHA is the housing authority that operates the Section 8 program out here. But, you know, I don't know if everybody that's watching is aware of that. Eden is a different one. I mean, the voucher programs, though, are far and away the best thing to do to mitigate the risks that come along with high-risk neighborhoods, which this one very much is, right? You have a lot of crime in this area, a lot of property damage, a lot of theft, right? Obviously, there is no furnace. There is no copper in this home, right? That has been long smoked, snorted, or shot, okay? That stuff's long gone. So if you get a seasoned landlord investor who's on the ground every day watching their properties like a hawk, understands the voucher system, knows how to maximize their rent, should have no problem getting $950 for this, and, you know, stays on top of the property, you can make a lot of money. You could save money on the renovation by getting there, doing some of the work yourself, or maybe you're a contractor who's got guys, you know, working and you need to keep them busy, right? If you can't give your guys a full 40, they're going to go look for the other GC out there. I mean, we're dealing with the labor shortage here, right? Y'all know how it is, right? So if you can't keep your people busy, they're going to find work elsewhere, right? So this is the type of people that make the most money on these properties. Out of state, folks, I know we got a lot of people watching HoltonWise TV from out of state. I love y'all. I just don't necessarily think this would be the best investment if you're brand new. If you want, like, HoltonWise to come in and do the renovation for you, just wouldn't pan out to a profitable deal. We shy away from doing renovations such as this one. It just makes staff in our company very tough when it's a neighborhood that is in such distress. You know, easier money to be made with less issues, right? And you get like a full force GC that you're paying, right? Notice I said earlier, you want it to be like an in-house GC, somebody that's, you know, getting the equity by doing their own labor. The margins are just going to probably get too thin, right? And I think a neighborhood like this, it's really far too advanced for the beginner landlord, right? For a beginner landlord, I suggest you guys check out the Ultimate Guide to Grading Cleveland Neighborhoods. I graded all the neighborhoods in the Cleveland market on an A to F scale, right? Doesn't necessarily mean A neighborhoods are better investment or F neighborhoods are worse investments. It's just grading them based upon risk, right? So this is what I would consider an F grade neighborhood, right? Highest possible risk, lowest possible price, right? The highest probability of property damage and crime happening is going to be in an F grade neighborhood. Lowest probability is going to be in an A grade neighborhood. Depending on what your real estate investment strategy is, you may want to try to do things in different neighborhoods. For out of state brand new investors, I find the risk reward on starting out in an F grade neighborhood not often panning out. For you folks, I would recommend you do like a C, possibly D, or a B neighborhood, right? Other strategies like Airbnb, right? I think those work best in A neighborhoods. I know, you know, all the liberal woke-ass MFers out there like to write articles about my company and that guide calling it racist. I find that to be ridiculous. I mean, dude, it's a guide. We need to provide substance to people who are investing so they know what they're getting into. Again, A does not mean better. F does not mean worse. It's an assessment of risk based upon a real estate investor, their money, right? Looking to see what type of risk they're putting out there when they're putting their money out there, right? You need to know what you're getting into, folks, right? So that's what I do here, right? I try to illustrate for you guys exactly what it is you're getting should you put your money on the table, right? And I try to fit the right people with the right properties and the right strategies. So for me personally, I believe the most logical chance of success for a real estate investor would be a local cat who does the work themselves or has an hourly crew who also has a ton of experience in government-subsidized landlording. I think that far and away is the smartest buyer with the highest chance of success of making a lot of money. But, of course, any other buyers out there that would like to take a stab at this one and want to pick up a cheap property, hey, man, highest and best offer gets it, folks. If you would like to make an offer on this property, send your offer to sales@HoltonWise.com. Include your proof of funds, right? Cash in the bank, folks. Not a hard money loan. Not cash in your buddy's bank account. Cash in your bank account. If you would like to get an on-the-ground physical tour, go in there, assess the property, do your scope of work, you can absolutely do that. If you're working with another real estate agent, have your buyer's agent go into the MLS. All of the showing instructions and what they need to do will be issued for them there, right? And then when you're ready, as is, cash offers only, folks, sales@HoltonWise.com. And then lastly, if you are one of those brand new out-of-state investors who's like, hey, man, I really appreciate the open and honest feedback you gave in regards to this property. I would like to work with you more, but I don't know if this is going to fit with me. Don't worry, people. We're going to take care of you, too. When you're done with this show, under the video, go ahead and click the link to book a free call with my team. We will get on the phone with you for free and figure out your wants, your needs, where you are in your real estate journey, and you will then get a set of customized videos from yours truly, matching you with the property that best fits your needs, based upon my assessment of what the heck's going on and what you tell me you're looking to do. That's it, folks. And if it's the first time here and you like what we're doing, make sure you hit the subscribe button on the way out.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to HoltonWiseTV for more financial information, education, and entertainment.